at Willow Springs today, Big Willow. Art of Attack, there's the case of their GR86. First time driving the car, super excited. I love NA rear-wheel drive platform, especially somewhat lightweight. So coming from an S2000, I have high hopes for this car, but let's see how it does.
Have fun, go fast, and what?
Don't suck.
Yeah, we just finished our first session here at Willow Springs. Lap time was a 33.1. Initial thoughts, it does feel like an S2000. However, being non-aero versus non-aero S2000, it really doesn't want to kill you as much, which makes it, I would say, definitely, as a first-timer in the car, more confidence-inspiring to me. Definitely think the car would benefit from a little bit more camber. Overall grip is good, but front end bite, especially at the top of Omega up there. As the car has a little bit of front lift and you're getting trying to turn the car down the hill, it could use a little more front bite, but I mean, it's the first time driving the car. Everything's great.
Came back in from session two. We're down to a 132.3. Not the coolest day per se, but yeah, it's fun. I gotta say, the more I drive this car, the more I love it. It has just enough power to be fun, and it requires just enough commitment to give you that thrill. I knew where I had to make some improvements. Turn one, the commitment to the brakes, getting right back on throttle. A big one was turn two. You can come in pretty much flat and hold it flat. Just more commitment through turn eight as well, coming in flat. I was a little bit scared at first, but my balls grew about 10%, I'd say. And yeah, it worked out. So shaved another second. Compared to an S2000, my fastest time in my S2000 here, granted it was years ago on an older technology tire, it was the first RE71R with aero. I did a 130 flat in the car. Keep in mind, I've had hundreds of track days in that car, and I knew that car like the back of my hand. And to be in this car for not even 10 laps, first time driving it, down to a 32, that says a lot with no aero. Granted, tire technology is newer, running the Mad King CRS, but it just goes to show how intuitive the damn car is. Yeah, I think I love this thing. Can we take a moment to like look at how red it is too? It's so red. And that's great. All cars should be red. But yeah, overall, damn good day. The only thing that I can see an improvement to make the car right now would be the brakes. Whether a little more of a brake pull, running an endless brake pad. So maybe something with a little more bite. I'm not sure which pad this is exactly, but definitely something with a little more bite and lasts a little longer would be great.
we saw the fault in the pads up in turn one. Turn one obviously is a very, very heavy braking zone after a long straight. So in order to make it through this lap fast, every corner matters, right? And turn one being as high speed as it is, you want as much entry, mid, and corner exit speed as possible. I mean, if that's the only thing that we have to improve, that's a small ask. Pass that first cone, hard on the brakes, stay on the right, turn the car in.
Okay.
That way you start from this corner, hit clip the inside, you want to end up right here.
Yeah.
It's like boom, turn the car in, throttle.
Are you snapping something? Or
here, lightly off, you want to use that all the way inside. You see how you're slowing down here?
Yeah.
Think about just adding one more mile an hour.
Okay.
That's all you got to think about. Don't even lay out, just think about, I want to add one more. Sessions and we're done for the day. I wish all track days were like this. It's awesome. Get in early and get home early. I would say it's a true driver's car. It does what you want, predictable, fast enough, not too fast. It has a lot of room for improvement. I mean, this thing is not super modded, so I mean, I can't wait to see what it does with Art's Future Aero and whatever Art of Attack has planned with this thing. So to wrap it up, really, third session we went out and just felt the car out, saw what we might be able to improve. If I had to complain about something, which I don't even want to, mid-quarter understeer, just a hair. Suspension settings-wise, we're on KW Club Sports. We love these coil lovers. Slowly tweak the alignment and maybe throw a better pad on it. It's really all the car needs. So, if you guys have a GR86, wheels, tires, lug and seats always number one on my list. Good brake pad and suspension is optional, but recommended. Come out and just have fun. God. Thanks, guys. Like and subscribe. It means the world to grow the channel. We're super stoked on the program, the GR86 program. So, from the sounds of it, we're going to be doing a lot more dope shit. Hopefully, you guys can follow along and see
what we do in the car.
We're going to go faster, that's no doubt. And most importantly, do it looking good. Thanks, guys.